cases of COVID-19.
COVID-19 pandemic.
Corona.
Coronavirus case.
California seeing a 2-week jump in cases.
COVID-19.
Coronavirus.
Hundreds were arrested in ongoing protests over police shootings.
Redemption for Golden State. One of the great playoff runs of all time is complete.
We're down over 16%.
The Supreme Court ruling on the Dreamers, blocking President Trump's plan to end the program.
A statewide emergency as those potentially historic winds fuel multiple wildfires.
With all the challenges this country faces right now, nobody can tell you, no, you're too young to understand, or this is how it's always been done. Because with so much uncertainty, with everything suddenly up for grabs, this is your generation's world to shape.
Welcome to Diaz's first virtual graduation video. We're gathered around our screens to celebrate and validate the graduating class of 2020. I'm Mariana Barsotti, your ASV president, and I'm honored to have the opportunity to speak in front of you all today and forever. First, I want to thank the parents, family, and friends for your constant love and support, as well as the Diaz's community, faculty, and staff for all of your love, guidance, and patience. We truly owe you all that we are. Secondly, I want to address our graduating class. We did it. We finally graduated. Be proud of yourself, as this is one of the first milestones of life. But it's far from over, and frankly, it's just begun. Graduating in the midst of a global pandemic and a revolution gives us an undeniable unique view of our destiny, one that will serve as a catalyst for us moving forward into the future. The world is changing and evolving, and we're destined to be those change makers. I encourage every single member of the DeAnza community, especially our graduating class, to embrace these events and do their part in this revolution. This could be joining a protest or having that uncomfortable conversation with your family. But I must know that it's our job to continue the fight and change the future. This battle against oppressive and unjust systems, which we all struggle under, has finally met its match with the loudest, strongest, most driven, most diverse, and biggest graduating class in DeAnza history. COVID-19, the revolution, and the missed events from our senior year might not have been a part of our plan, but it's a part of our vision for a better future, one that's of our creation, one in which we can envision a better future for ourselves and the rest of the world. And that change starts now with a clear 2020 vision. Now, without further ado, let's get this graduation started.
Dear class of 2020, my name is Ifani Ashedu, and I stand here as another proud African-American valedictorian for DeAnza. But I want to get something off my chest, something I've kept a secret for a very long time. When I was almost a year old, I got really sick. I was taken to the hospital, and it turns out that I had a nuisance called sickle cell anemia, a rare blood disorder that causes red blood cells to slim down, get stuck in veins, and cause pain. That is my obstacle that I have been dealing with for 18 years so far. So if you've seen me around at school one day and all of a sudden I've gone for a week or 2 weeks, except the time I went to Japan, of course, that's why. I'm telling you all this now because this obstacle has made me stronger and I no longer want to hide it. Now that I've gotten that off my chest, enough about me. The class of 2020 is the strongest class. No other class from this point forward can compare themselves to us. I mean, we're graduating in a pandemic and got a shout out from Obama. We are one of the largest, if not the largest, graduating class that DeAnza has ever had. I'm grateful that I attended a school that is so diverse. For 4 years, we've come across students of different backgrounds and different stories, never the same. We've had crazy experiences, made lifelong friends, and have close bonds to teachers and advisors who encouraged us to keep fighting through each individual obstacle that each of us may have. Most of us are going our separate ways, and we probably won't see each other for a very long time. I can't believe that I've known some of you guys since kindergarten. Graduating high school is the last step in our lives before we officially start making our own decisions. We will have a lot less help than we've had during our time in high school. It will be our job to find a person like Ms. Smith or Ms. Nunez who is willing to help us even at uncertain times, because there are so many people in the real world who are not like them. It will be our job to find a Mr. Mejia or Mr. Nam, excuse me, Mr. Kang, that will be there to uplift our spirits, even though they may make you cringe with their jokes and cause secondhand embarrassment. You never realize how much people like them have a positive impact on our lives. I know this is not the way we wanted to graduate, but it is the way for us. It's not going to stop us from the fun and crazy experiences we will have in the future. There will be many more obstacles that we will have to go through, and that's okay because that's what makes us strong, persevering people. Dear class of 2020, we are the force of change. We have the potential to make the world a better place. We can start that by making our voices heard. Please go submit that ballot in November. Go become something big. Go be the bigger person. Change lives, start a movement, drink water and not Lysol because it will help your blood flow better. Hopefully we can meet again soon, and if we do, I hope it will be safe enough so that I can shake your hand, give you a hug, and have that long-awaited silly conversation. Thank you, and go Dons.
My name's Tom Panis, and on behalf of the Board of Education, it's my pleasure to welcome you to our virtual graduation. We are all so proud of you. Hola, buenos dias. Mi nombre es Tom Panis, y como representante de la mesa directiva, tengo el placer de darle la bienvenida a nuestra graduación virtual. Todos son muy orgullosos de usted. I'd like to thank you for the hard work you've done and also thank your families, your friends, and the community that helped you graduate. me gustaría agradecerle por el arduo trabajo que han realizado y también a sus familias, amigos y la comunidad que lo ayudaron a graduarse. This is a wonderful milestone, but there's always more to learn. Many of the challenges you face will involve working with other people. Being a good listener will help you stand out from the crowd. Invest time in developing this skill. A good listener always listens with their eyes, their ears, and their heart. Cuando escucha, siempre escucha con sus oídos, con sus ojos y su corazón. That's powerful advice. Please always use your eyes, your ears, and your heart whenever you listen. I'm almost 70 years old, and I've made a lot of decisions. At the time, most of them didn't seem very important. But looking back, it's stunning to see the impact that many of those casual decisions have had on thousands of people. In saying this, I am not telling you to be overly cautious. Graduates, that's worth repeating, do not be overly cautious. In fact, please be courageous and seize opportunity whenever you have a choice. Graduados, voy a decir eso otra vez. No estoy diciendo que sean muy cuidadosos. De hecho, estoy sugiriendo todo lo contrario. Por favor, sean valientes. Aprovecha la oportunidad cada vez que tengan una opción. Shirley Chisholm famously said, "If they don't give you a seat at the table, bring a folding chair." Please, don't be afraid to seize opportunity when you have a chance. Malala Yousafzai once said, "When the whole world is silent, even one voice becomes powerful." So listen to the courage of your own voice. Escucha al coraje de su propia voz. Don't follow the path. Go where there's no path and begin the trail. Crea caminos y puentes. Crea esperanza. Anas Nin wrote, "Life shrinks or expands in proportion to one's courage." Truer words were never spoken. It's up to you to make your own luck. No one else is going to make it for you. So many amazing and unexpected things have happened to me when I got out of my comfort zone and stuck out my neck. Tantas cosas sorprendentes y inesperadas me han sucedido cuando salí de mi zona de comodidad y tomé un riesgo. The same will be true for you. So stick out your neck. Teach yourself to get comfortable with being uncomfortable. Aprovecha oportunidades. Enséñese a sentirse cómodo con lo incómodo. If you do this, you will find success almost everywhere life takes you, and you'll be able to become the change you want to see in the world. Por favor, nunca olvide a su familia, a sus amigos y su comunidad. Está rodeado de personas que siempre quieran ayudarse. Todos quieren que usted tenga éxito. Please never forget your friends, your family, and your community. You're surrounded by people who want to help you. Buena suerte a nuestros muy queridos graduados. Solo hazlo. Thank you and good luck.
Hey seniors, I'm Alyssa Votto, a junior at De Anza High School. And I know that not all of you know me, but that's all right. I just wanted to do something special for the class of 2020 since it didn't exactly go as planned. But I just wanted to let you know that so many people love you and so many people are looking forward to seeing what you can do in the future. And I just wanted to say, I got the amazing opportunity to meet so many great people in my classes, on the sports teams, and I'm just so blessed to have met you guys. You really do impact all the other grades, and I just want to say I'm excited to see you guys grow. Okay, thank you.
So, what did the farmer say when he lost his tractor? Where's my tractor? Well, now that I've eased you guys all into my speech with a pretty terrible joke, hello everyone, and thanks for coming. Students, teachers, families, everyone else is going to be there that I don't really know how to categorize into. I am Matthew Hua, the salutatorian of De Anza High School. So, quite a graduation we're having here right now, huh? Not really what we really wanted, you know, being the whole drive-through and everything, not in a very stuffy auditorium. But we do have to do and adapt at the current times and the situation. I don't think this speech should be so formal, since probably the others who are giving a speech already gave a pretty heartwarming and serious one. So, I like to be a little bit more casual with my speech. I mean, after all, this ain't a coronation crowning the next king or queen. It's a celebration. We should be having fun, enjoying the time we have together now, and congratulate each other on what we've done. What I think we should all be doing at the moment is congratulating the students who are graduating this year. Time sure did fly by, huh? Past 4 years of high school. Or maybe not. Maybe time didn't fly by. Maybe it took forever. But you guys spent the last 13 years at school, from fall to summer. And let me tell you, whether you're a student or not, I think you can all relate that it gets pretty exhausting. I mean, take the last 2 months especially as an example. Lazing around at home, looking through our screens, learning digitally. It gets pretty stale, just doing the same thing over and over again. I mean, that's what we do at school, but now we're doing even less. On the bright side though, we do have our own personal bathrooms instead of the one pair we always keep open at school and not the rest. But the last 4 years has become quite a unique experience for me, and I like to say a unique experience for all of you guys too. Walking down those crowded hallways over and over again, a little bit too much than I'd like to say. Yeah, filled with memories that we've created for the past 4 years. I'd like to take some time to thank some teachers. I mean, if we didn't have teachers, who would be teaching us in the first place? So, first of all, Ms. Ching, I think everyone can agree that you made math enjoyable, at the least bearable for us. Mr. Nam, or Mr. Kang, I guess, since that's what you go by now, you made our class and a literal guinea pig for your first year teaching at De Anza High School. And I like to say that you did a pretty alright job. I think we did pretty fine. Mr. Gagne, you're also thrust into a situation that none of us expected, and I like to say thank you for being able to salvage what was left. Ms. M, biology was fun, and I can indeed, for certain, reconfirm because of that the mitochondria is indeed the powerhouse of the cell. Mr. Smith, psychologically speaking, there is no psychological thinking behind these words of mine. Thank you. I've loved psychology, and being able to be in your class, I've come to understand it more and love it even more than what I had before. Ms. Nunez, your class was fun, and all that I can remember right now was the trip to Hamilton and watching the play, because it was just so much fun being there. Mr. Dominic Economic, your dad jokes were amazing, and because of that, I've come to learn more about dad jokes and say some of my own. And I don't think that's a good thing, but I do appreciate it. And to all the teachers in the Health Academy, all I can really say is, what do you call an inflammation to an eye? If you guys know that one, then you know that one, and I'll just leave it at that. Ms. Smith, for the amount of essays and pieces of literature that you had us do and read, what really sticks out to me and stays with me are two simple words, and I think I'll leave that for the end of this speech, actually. Every person at the school made the experience there oh so unique. And that includes you teachers too. I mean, you guys have to deal with about 200 students a day. I personally don't think I'd be able to handle that. Even the other various staff members at school made the experience there unique. The College Career Center, thank you for the snacks when I was there. The cafeteria ladies, you guys provided us food. The janitors, I mean, we'd be swimming in a pile of trash if you guys weren't there. And the ice cream truck man, who's not really part of the staff, but is always there after school. You guys, you're pretty much considered a staff member in my eyes, so thank you. But there are some people I don't think we really thank during graduation, and that's our family. Us students have basically been dependent on you guys since birth. I mean, without you guys, we wouldn't even be born. You've nurtured us and watched us grow up into very responsible, mature young adults. I can't express this enough. you guys were the backbone for us students, and without you guys, we'd probably fallen apart much sooner. So give you guys a pat on the back, or a applause, or a honk, whatever you guys want to do. I don't really know how it's going to work out, but yeah. Once again, thank you everyone for being here. We've all played a part in allowing this year's of seniors to graduate. This graduation isn't just a celebration for us students. It's a congratulations for everyone here who helped us along the way. As you all know, closing out this metaphorical chapter of our metaphorical story doesn't mean the end of it. It just opens up another metaphorical chapter in our metaphorical story. And yes, I am indeed saying metaphorical for as much as I want because, it's metaphorical. Closing out this speech, I'll now say the two words that were foreshadowed previously in this speech. Carpe diem. Thank you guys, and happy graduation.
Congratulations, class of 2020. On behalf of all of the staff of De Anza, we are so proud of you and all of your accomplishments. You truly are the go big or go home class. In 4 years with us, you have gone big many times. You are a class of ideals and opinions. Earlier this year, when you knew what time you wanted football games, you made it known, you made it heard, you made it happen. Up to now, with your graduation, you had a vision for graduation and you didn't stop fighting until you achieved that vision. That's a quality that's going to take you a long way in life. You've also had an interrupted senior year. The interruptions, in the long run, are going to make you stronger. Because every time you've had an interruption, you've had to respond and to think about what does it look like to approach this problem with compassion and strength. In a time where all of us are being asked to think deeply about the greater good, I know you all are prepared to go out into the world. So next year, when you're spread across many different states and in many different places, we ask that you remember us and the lessons that we learned today. And don't forget that no matter where you are, it's always a great day to be a Don.
I would have to disagree. Our journey started when we stepped foot onto this campus. Today just happens to be the day where the journey splits into unique roads. Up until now, we all have been a team walking as one. We have done it all and we have done it together. Now, let me take us back to August 22nd, 2016, where we first started our high school journey. When we walked onto this campus on the first day, I was positive that every student had the same thought. Why are these halls so crowded? But one thing you do see as you walk down these halls were hardworking and dedicated students. The class of 2020 has always worked extremely hard, and I'm proud of you all. As senior year started, everyone was excited. We were looking forward to the senior events that we have all been awaiting for since freshman year. As months went on, our senioritis was getting to the best of us, but we kept pushing because we were so close to the end. But unfortunately, the end came sooner than we thought, but it wasn't a break for us as a class. We're strong. This part of the journey is only making us stronger. We all have worked hard in these years, and these years have been nothing but success. So now, here we are. It probably isn't the way we want it to be, but we always make the best of everything. The road we have been walking for these past years has led us to this day. This is the moment we all stop and reflect on how far we've come, how many friends we've made, and how many memories we've created. We stuck together and grew together through everything, and I could not have chosen a better class to be a part of. I'm truly proud of each and every one of you, and no matter which road each of you choose to travel, I believe that you will make it your own and be successful. Now it is time to keep our heads up and take a step forward into our split paths. It has been an amazing journey with you all. Class of 2020, you will always hold a special place in my heart. Thank you for all of the memories. With love, your senior class president, Ashley Gidding.
Now, by the authority vested in me, by the Board of Education of the West Contra Costa Unified School District and the State of California, I hereby certify that the graduates seated before me have met all requirements for graduation of the West Contra Costa Unified School District and the State of California, and I hereby accept them as graduates of the class of 2020. Congratulations.
Hi, everybody. Steve Kerr from the Golden State Warriors. I wanted to take this opportunity to say congratulations to the class of 2020. Everyone in the Bay Area is extremely proud of you and your accomplishment, especially under such difficult circumstances over the past several months. As any coach would tell you, you're going to face a lot of adversity at some point in the game, or in this case, in life. And to persevere through that adversity is really what's going to set you apart and make you a champion. You guys have crossed the first hurdle, should be really commended for that. And I just want to say congratulations again. Go make the Bay Area proud.
Greetings, everyone. Bob Myers with the Golden State Warriors. First of all, I wanted to say congratulations to the class of 2020. Outstanding work by each and every one of you. All the long days, homework, and study hall are in the past. Now, you can focus on the future. And as we have experienced over the last year, the future might have its bumps and bruises. But regardless of what is thrown in your direction, and the road will not always be straight and perfect, stay positive and plug forward. You too can be a champion. Congrats again, and go strive for greatness.
What's going on, everyone? It's Juan Toscano Anderson of the Golden State Warriors, Cache Valley High alum, class of 2011. I myself am also from the Bay Area, and it doesn't seem like 9 years ago when I graduated, but regardless of how long it's been since I was in your shoes, congratulations to this year's graduates, the class of 2020. Although with everything that's going on, I understand you guys can be a little discouraged and trying to figure out what's going to happen next in your life. Just stay positive. You know, things will pass over. Keep your goals there. Keep your dreams there. Follow them. Do whatever you want. Do whatever you put your minds to. I myself never thought that I would be in the NBA. And just like you guys, I'm also from the Bay Area. So if I can do it, you guys can do it as well. I encourage you guys to continue to stay positive and just continue to stay persistent. Stay safe, stay healthy. And if you really want to do it right, follow it in this guy's next steps.
Hey, everybody. Stephen Curry here from the Golden State Warriors. Congratulations to the Bay Area class of 2020. You guys did it. And you did it under some pretty unique and uncertain circumstances, to say the least. So congratulations. Now it's time to go out and conquer the world. As the last few months have taught everybody, expect the unexpected, be able to adapt, but don't let anything stand in your way. I'm a firm believer in the mantra, I can do all things, and I hope you are too. So now it's time to go and live that out every single day. Congratulations again. We got you. Rooting for you guys. All the support and love. Peace.